In this video, I'll show how to investigate and act on email messages in Microsoft Defender for Office 365. In Explorer, select a suspicious email to get started. This opens the Email Summary side pane, which contains a lot of helpful information about the delivery, email headers, URLs, and any file attachments. If the email gives you reason to be wary, take a closer look. To do that, select Open Email Entity to open the Email Entity page. On the left side, you see the same detection and email details as before. The tabs describe events surrounding the email, our in-depth analysis of it, including the email header, any file attachments, or URLs it contains, and similar emails found in your tenant. There are additional actions you can take right here on the Email Entity page. For example, you can select Email Preview to see the actual email you're investigating, so you don't have to ask users to forward samples. And select the More Actions menu, followed by Download Email, to download a copy of the message to a local file. Maybe you'd like to see the HTML code in the message itself. After investigating the email, you likely have a clear idea of what to do with it, and we make it as easy as possible to take those actions. In fact, you can act on multiple messages at a time. Just select one or more emails, followed by Take Action. There are four options here: Move or Delete, Submit to Microsoft for Review, Initiate Automated Investigation, and Propose Remediation. I'll focus on the first two. First, select Move or Delete. You have the option to move the emails to the Junk, Inbox, Deleted Items, Soft Deleted Items, or Hard Deleted Items. However, depending on the email's current location, some of those choices might not be available, but you can enable them by selecting Show All Response Actions. In this case, I'll select Soft Deleted Items to delete the emails while allowing their recovery. Hard Deleted Items cannot be recovered. If it's an outgoing message, you can also select Delete Sender's Copy to delete the message from the sender's Sent Items folder. Next, select Submit to Microsoft for Review. We recommend you do this to help tune our detection filters. You also have the choice between It Appears Suspicious and I've Confirmed It's a Threat. Note the wording. Select I've Confirmed It's a Threat, which gives me the opportunity to add indicators to the tenant allow block list, and then indicate what type of threat it is: spam, phish, or malware. In this case, I'll choose phish. That opens the details side pane with a list of entities you can block in the tenant allow block list. These can include email addresses, domains, URLs, file attachments, and more. Select the ones you want to block, being mindful that some of them will be good, and then select Add to Block Rule. By default, these entries never expire. If you want to set an expiration date for them, select Never Expire to turn it off and pick a date. On the next page, type a name and description that will appear in the Action Center, Tenant Allow Block List, and other pages. And then, have a look at all the actions we're going to do on your behalf. That's a lot of work done with just a few mouse clicks. When you're ready, select Submit to get the ball rolling. Defender for Office 365 offers powerful tools to help security teams act on malicious emails. To learn more about these tools, see our documentation on Microsoft Docs.